You can tell it's going to be a stunning morning. I'm already on the case, stringing out the string line and working out foundations and things. So, yeah, I'll be starting off in here, digging the foundations needed to complete the pergola. Oh, goodness. I've been digging out the foundations here for the two little, I guess they're balustrading walls more than anything else. They're certainly not retaining walls because this is all foundation up to the ground height. I'll be packing this with a lot of crush rock and pushing it in with a compactor as well, just to make sure it's really, really solidly crushed down. And then I'll put the foundations in by wiring up trench mesh and whatnot and pouring the concrete in here. And then on top of that, I'll build a brick wall initially to bring it out of the ground and skinned on the inside in brick, in red brick, just like the pillars over there. And on the outside, it'll be lined in the same cold stream rock as we've got here. So it'll just be a 900 mil wall to stop people from falling out of the pergola. Should be good. Well, I'm quite close to getting ready to pour this in concrete. I've leveled off the top surface here with some crushed rock, which of course I'll be tampering down once the foundation and the initial brick and rock work is done. But for now, what I've got here is trench mesh down in a 500 deep in that one, and it's 300 deep here. And that's to take the weight of two posts that will be here, and a small wall, which will be pretty much a balustrading for the pergola here. There'll be a little gap between them, and then there'll be another post here, which is 600 deep, it's quite deep, and a 300 deep at the other end. So it's, while it's level to the trench mesh, the ground is sort of sloping there. But basically I've got starter bars coming up to enable the wall to be quite strong and reinforced from the inside. It'll be brick on the inside and clad in stone on the outside, and the starter bars will go in the middle of it to keep it all nice and stable. And Schnozzy's here to come and check it out. What do you think, Schnoz? Is it good? I think you should be looking here. Yeah, there you go. All right. Goodness. Well, I've taken one of these down already, but this is another one of those occasions where you thank your lucky stars you've got a helper like the Schepak, the Schlepper, the Schlepper machine. These are not light, and just to get them on, I'm just sort of rolling them off the trailer and onto here, and then transporting them down to the back of the property, which, you know, if I was doing that in a wheelbarrow, it'd be, that'd be very, very hard work. Well, I got them down here. Yeah, a bit puffed because I've been just giving these a bit of a wire brush, but look how good the timber is. It's just really nice. It's got this sort of yellowish grey, some of it's blue. Yeah, once that's sealed a bit, which I'm going to use a oil-based sealer so it really penetrates and protects the timber before I put them into position, should look fantastic. So this is what the saddles should look like once they're put together. This is just dry fitted together, it's not welded yet. Basically it'll have two bolts that will be drilled through the timbers which will sit inside the centre there in that cradle, and that will keep it secure. And actually it'll make it very easy for me to stand up the timbers, sit them inside, and this structure will keep them upright while I then go and drill the holes and fit everything off. And to hold it into the ground, this will be welded to the bottom of the whole thing in the middle. It's a bit of pretty thick tube, and I'm going to core that into the concrete I poured and chem set it in place so that it can't move, and that'll keep it pretty rigid. So anyway, this is sort of my answer for making a more custom looking cradle that you certainly couldn't buy at Bunnings. And because it's made of 6mm core 10, it's going to last a long, long time. It will rust off and get a nice patina. And I could just let it rust on its own. It would take forever for it to rust through. But I might just hit it with some clear coat at some point just to make sure that it, you know, it's protected to some degree, or give it some oil. But yeah, that's sort of the plan anyway. Okay, getting pretty seriously technical here. I've put an overhead beam here just to basically help line up the holes I now need to drill into the concrete. And yeah, I've positioned the box where I want it, and I can see that that's pretty much in the center of that box. I know you probably think that's different, but it is, it's pretty central. And I'm going to mark these, and then using this fairly amazing drill bit, which I've hired, got this device here with this incredible coring bit, and I can drill down to 250mm with this. It's assisted by some water that comes out of this tank and goes into this inlet here, and yeah, basically you just hang on to dig life and drill away until you get your desired depth. So that's what I'm about to do. I'm just going to make sure that the other holes are also marked, and then I'll go ahead and start. Okay, the first result's quite good. I mean, obviously, big machine, really good. And a 65mm hole just cored into the concrete like that. There's the core. That's pretty cool. So I went a little bit too deep, but that's okay. I can always chuck some stuff in the bottom of it and lift the tubing out, and I'll squeeze chemset in anyway. So yeah, it's going to be pretty well bonded. It'll sit pretty tight. Plus the bottom of the saddle will sit on bricks anyway. So you know, it's all really over-engineered, but certainly will do a great job of holding the very large timbers in place. I'm just refilling this tank with water, and I've only got through four of them. Well, I'm on the fourth one at the moment, so that's not bad. I've just got to go down another, say, 120mm on that one, and then the final one's over here. It's been a little while for updates here. It's mainly because of the weather. It's been quite wet and cold here in Melbourne, and it's been difficult to do things. But anyway, I finally installed these saddles or stirrups. They're basically custom made using the plasma cutter, as some might have seen already. And they've been aligned up so that they basically form a level to the ground here. And eventually we'll be putting our very large railway timbers in here as posts for the pergola. So before I do that though, I'm going to brick up underneath these and support them with mortar, just so that they're as strong as they can be before I start manhandling these very large, heavy railway timbers, which come from a bridge. And they've been pre-oiled and pre-stained so that they're basically protected from the weather already. And once I stand them up, I'll get them into level, and then I'll drill and put bolts through them, and we'll support them temporarily with some stays while I then begin to brick up the inside and then stone up the outside between the posts, and then that will pretty much keep it rigid. The final step, of course, will be to put the timbers at the top in and bolt them in before completion as well, so that it is all level and it is all vertical and so forth. So yeah, that's what's going to happen next. The timbers in here will look fantastic. Can't wait to see it. Well, today we finally put the timbers up to set the saddles the stirrups into position using Chemset, which is a chemical fixing agent that you use for structural engineering type works. And these stirrups have now been locked into place, which is fantastic, with everything set straight and vertical. And we're just going to let that go off for the rest of today, and tomorrow it'll be a case of bricking up and mortaring underneath these posts, underneath the stirrups, and securing everything in place so it can't spin or, you know, be forced out in any way, so that we can support it. And then the process of infilling it with stone will happen. We'll be building a wall about 900 high in through here, which will go between the posts, and that will help keep everything pretty rigid. And then overhead, we'll of course have timbers that will head back to the wall over there. So the entire thing will be about just under 20 square meters of pergola with some pretty heavy chunky timbers. So I really love the look of it. I think once the rafters and the battens are on, and of course things like vines growing over it, it should look pretty amazing. So yeah, I mean, okay, we have to take these timbers out one more time just to check in all the timbers up there. It's too hard to do it in place because this timber is iron bark. It's pretty hard timber to work with. So I'm going to use a drop saw and do lots of kerf cuts to get the checkouts happening properly, and then bring it in with a, once I've chiseled it all and sanded it all fine, and make sure it's all sealed as well. And we'll set them in place, put the bolts through the plates down there, put some plates on the top as well, and it will be super rigid. Yeah, anyway, little update for today. We're very happy with this sort of progress because we've been held up by weather and jobs and everything else, so life in general just getting in the way. Well, we're back to brickwork again. This is basically just bricked in, roughed in. This is below ground still, but is going to be helping to support the stirrups there for the uprights. And we've basically got it now to the point where I think I can let it set here, and then I can take the timbers back out after I mark them off exactly where they need to be cut off and where they need to be checked in. So I'll let this set for a couple of days, if not 3-4 days actually, and see how it goes for weather wise and then I'll bring in the, go buy the timbers for the top area, and we'll start putting in the frame for the top. So that should be exciting. And then after that, we can start bricking all the way in between, right up to the full height, which is about 900 high. And we're also going to stone on the outside here so that that will be clad in stone. Okay, well, I'm basically correcting a small issue I've had here, and it's basically because this point here in space is actually non-existent, but these two points must meet for the roof line to work. So even though we're not building this section, these lines must come together at this point. So yeah, it's been a bit of an issue just getting this to be, well, this is level and fairly easy to get right. It wasn't so easy getting this angle just with, you know, my little setup here, until I set up a flying point in space there to get this angle correct. So now I'm confident I can withdraw, or you know, check out the material a bit lower on these two posts, and it will all work and come together at the end, which is perfect. Thank you. Okay, update from the Pergola project. I've put on that last rafter on the end here and I've screwed everything down. I've got a lot of bolts and bolted brackets and things in here now, all the way through. Plus over here there's plates of steel basically hugging the corners, and every rafter's been put on pretty strong as well. Yeah, it's taken a long time to do it all. Even did all these little guys here, so these are nice and bracketed in. And so I think I've now got to the point where the above structure is done until I do the battens. And once the battens are on, it will be quite rigid. The final thing that really will make it quite rigid is the brick walls that I'm going to put in through here. So that's next. I'm hopefully going to start doing that tomorrow. Well, I started early this morning because despite the fact it's prediction of heavy rain and everything like that, we've got fairly blue skies at the moment, so I'm going to take advantage of that. And I've made my first mix already, and I'm going to start on this little wall and try and get it up to, you know, the full height if I can, and also complete that last little bit that's missing. But gee, I tell you what, it's looking good this morning. I'm really excited how the sun is still working on its magic on this wall, and we've got this sort of balustrading wall here to stop people from falling out into the open there, into the abyss. But yeah, anyway, I'm going to start my work, try and get this laid out quickly, and then get inside before it starts pouring with rain. I just had a look at the weather map, and oh my god, there's Armageddon coming our way. But you wouldn't know it because, you know, blue sky here and sunny conditions, it seems like it's quite reasonable, but no, there's some very big rain coming. But I've got halfway already, and I've completed this wall over here now. I've put the two bricks over there. And I'm about halfway up this wall here. I'm moving as fast as I can with a pretty sticky mix to help it set in place quickly. And it's looking good. I really love the way the walls are coming up, and you can really see the shape of the building now. Okay, well, the weather is certainly starting to turn now. The sun is literally just disappearing behind some pretty heavy clouds, but look at this. I managed to get this wall up as well. It still needs a lot of cleaning, and Schnoz approves, which is great. Thank you, Ada. And I've started doing the rock work on the outside here. It needs massive amount of cleaning up still, and backfilling with concrete. And these starter bars and these ties to the wall on the other side will knit everything together as one big solid mass, which goes into the foundation, preventing this from racking with the wind and, you know, over the years, maybe a bit of slumpage here and there. So I'm hoping it all stays pretty stiff. And so the final thing is that we're going to use some of the pine that we milled. You know, we cut down some very tall pine trees here, and some of them are suitable to cut into, you know, bench tops and things. So we're going to put bench tops up here for the beer. You can put your beer there while you're looking out onto the savannah here. That's the idea anyway. And in here we're going to put in a Core 10 barrier, which will prevent mostly, you know, just people falling out of here, but also the lavender that we're going to grow on the other side with the bees and, you know, the flowers sticking into your face here. So we'll keep it, I guess, under control with a piece of Core 10. And that'll keep it light, fairly lightweight, and just breaks up the monotony of just brick everywhere. And so I'll just walk over here. I've still got all my building equipment in the way, but at least we can start to see the overall effect of the whole building. I'm really happy with it. It looks fantastic, and it lets the sunlight under through those windows there in winter time, but in summertime when it's shaded with vines and things over the top, this wall should be kept fairly heat free, cool, and will help to make it more bearable down here, which it can get very hot during summer. So yeah, super happy. Flagstone's going to go on the floor, and of course one big long table on this side with a sort of walkway through the middle here. All right, after a little quick lunch break, I've come back down to just try and clean up before this storm sort of hits. And yeah, I've kind of wire brushed the wall from yesterday down and really cleaned up. So it just needs an acid wash once it's fully set now. Whereas the other side still unfortunately is very wet, so I can't really fully brush it down as I'd like to. But that's okay. I'll come back tomorrow and do that if I can. Even if it's in the rain, it's only a small wall. Schnoz is here with me. And I've tried to clean up this area here, which I started rocking, but you can see that that's really going to look good in there and blend in with the stonework that's already here. So yeah, I think overall looking really good. Yeah, it looks a bit rough on this side now until that stone is up, so I'm definitely going to be keen to try and get that done as quickly as possible. And once this wall has set, along with that one, I can take away these braces finally, and that'll be fine. Well, today was not really much of a building day. I've basically brought down, went and selected all these rocks from the quarry. I've got a lot more around the corner here, which I'll quickly show you, and I'll come back to this wall. Yeah, we've basically got them all ready to go so they can be laid into this wall here and clad the outside of this brick wall. And of course, as I go along, I have to backfill with concrete, which is what I've done here, so that tomorrow, apparently we're going to have no power, so I'm going to have to hand mix every load if I want to do any mortar work, which is... it's not a big deal, but just overall it just makes everything harder. But anyway, so I'm hoping that I can get these little balustrading walls clad as soon as I can, and then we'll acid wash, clean them, seal any timber work that needs painting and whatnot, like this upper area needs to be done, and then finally put in the capping timbers, which will be a slab of pine in between these two, these posts, as well as that little one, which will act as kind of like bench tops, and just to help finish it off and give it a softer edge rather than the stone. And then we'll also need to put in another piece of timber here to bring this back up to height, and backfill it with soil in here so that we can then plant our herbs and whatnot that we'll put in the front here. And then finally, a piece of core 10 to go in there, and then plant this out in lavender in the middle, and each end will get a vine, a grapevine that'll climb up onto the trellising there and hopefully produce some grapes. That'd be nice. What have you found, Schnoz? Truffles? Drugs or truffles? Oh, come on, Ada. Anyway, here's a little update of today. Bronster has done a fantastic job of laying up almost right to the very top there, actually. And we're going to set this railway spike nail, into this position here. And then on the very top, we'll have a piece of live edge pine that was originally grown from this location, cut down and milled. And so that'll be the top. And we'll seal it and oil it and whatnot to protect it. And then that will be the sort of final treatment for it. But yeah, we're getting close to the completion of at least the walls and the framework. And we've still got this area to do, which is a considerable amount of work, but I think we can achieve it by the weekend, which should be great. Well, good morning. It's Saturday morning before the rains, and look, he's already hard at work putting together the finishing touches, including the nail that's the railway nail, which is going to be used as a basket hanger.
Yeah,
very cool.
I've been here since 6 a.m.
Oh,
quite
you
light.
Lie, you know. Schnoz is with us. Good deal. And yeah, we're continuing on the work here. And I'm going to continue to bring more soil in. The reason why, of course, is because very shortly we're going to be putting the paving down, and I don't really want to be running over it with my motorized tractor, so I've had to refill the soil here since it had sunken quite a lot. But it's looking much, much better. This soil is fairly lifeless, but there's plenty of life underneath it. And I'll be putting mulch and things over the top of it to introduce more life as well and give it a bit more protection from weeds and things. So it should be really, really solid, at least for a while. It'll sink again, and we'll just keep topping it up probably with wheelbarrows from that point on, just normal wheelbarrows, not motorized wheelbarrows. These terraces, no problem, because I can run the four-wheel drive wheelbarrow through here. And yeah, you can see just how much it's dropped. It's pretty much dropped, I'd say, 10 centimetres across the board. But down here, on the top terrace here, it had sunk by at least 40, maybe even 50 centimetres in parts. So it required 5 trailer loads of soil in here. It was an all-day affair just bringing in the soil yesterday. But yeah, I'll be finishing it off today. Well, Saturday afternoon, we managed to get most things done. Look at what Bronster's done. She's been able to complete this wall. That was done earlier today. And she's dry laid the top of this. So now, once that's mortared in tomorrow, we'll be able to acid wash it and then seal it just like the wall over here. So it'll have a very similar look to it, which will be nice. And for me, today was just, again, just bringing in tons and tons of soil. This is all organic mix and not just soil, but yeah, it's still down a little bit from where it needs to be, and I'll probably make up a lot of that with other composts and mulch, A, to keep the weeds down, but also to bring in the life, as said before. But yeah, this has made a huge difference, because now the land is sort of draining nicely down the hill. You get the full permaculture value out of it, because one terrace literally feeds the next terrace, which then drops down to the next terrace and so forth. So we get to reuse the water as much as we possibly can. And yeah, we're almost at the point where we could actually start planting the citrus and olives in. Finally, we'll put together the citrus and olive grove. There is still a little bit more left to do in terms of stoning. We've still got the other side of these brick walls here. And I'll quickly walk you around there to have a look. Lavender will be here. We've just potted these guys from another spot. And yeah, this is the wall that's currently in progress. Halfway up most of the way. I think we'll probably get most of it done tomorrow. And that will mean that we can acid wash it, clean it, maybe Monday, Tuesday. And then finally we can put the pieces of pine tops, of the little bench tops on the top of these, which will definitely make it feel a lot more complete. Then in the lower section here, we've got a missing board in here which needs to go in, and then it'll be backfilled with more soil, and that can be planted out with herbs and that and the like. And we've got some hanging baskets going on the wall as well, so it'll be great for little impromptu breakfasts and barbecue events under the pergola. We can just pick from the surrounding area the things that we need. Anyway, that's it for the day. That was a massive effort again. We've got a lot of grey coffees overhead, so hopefully you can hear me, but I've just started acid washing this wall, the one on the right over here, and I just wanted to show you the difference it does make to the finished look. Getting all the lime and the cementy bits off the front face of the brick really just helps to clean it up, and we'll obviously seal it like these ones here, to give it a slightly wet look as well, and to make it very easy to keep clean and keep free of spiders and stuff like that. So I think the acid washing is definitely something that we need to do here. It's not always needed though. Sometimes this look is kind of cool, just not in this circumstance. Alright, and Bronte's working hard here at filling in, mudding in the last capping stones on the wall here, and that will see the end of this side at least, which is really looking great, looking fantastic. Nice and level for a pot, a couple of pots, terracotta pots, to hold vines that will grow up the side of the pergola here. And while we don't have quite enough lavender here, we'll get some more to plant into this little area, and we're going to put vines at each end as well, so there's going to be quite a few vines growing on here, and whichever one survives the most I guess will be the winner. And we haven't started on this wall yet, but we're hoping to get through this as well. Wow, this has now been laid. That looks really, really good. Bronte's done a fabulous job of that, just sort of cleaning obviously. Ada's communicating. Good to see you keeping an eye on things. And meanwhile, the master's quietly at work here. Yeah, jigsaw puzzle coming together. Apart from making lots and lots of mixes and, of course, dealing with the acid washing of the two brick walls there, I've also been bringing in mulch to basically cover the whole area at the top end. Still got a little bit to go, but basically done. And this will help, you know, control the weeds and everything, and it'll provide a lot of life into the ground. It's amazing how many witchetty grubs and worms and all sorts of things are in here, and that is just seriously going to make a great difference to the soil. So we're getting closer and closer to finishing off sort of the dirty end of the work, and that's all just so that I can then level off in here and bring in some packing sand and basically whack it down with a whacker. And after that, we can start laying the paving tiles that are going to go down here. And I won't need to constantly bring soils and things across here. So yeah, pretty happy about getting this sort of dirty work done, and then we'll concentrate on cleaning it all up. Well, it's pretty satisfying acid washing the stone, not for the final time, but I think getting close. That's cleaning up really lovely, and I've even gone to the trouble of doing the new wall here, which isn't even complete yet, so this will get dirty again, but at least it keeps the majority of it off, even while we're laying, just so you can see the colour and the shape of things. And over here, where the wall is complete, I mean, it's just got a brilliant luster to it, and beautiful colour, and once the sealer is put on it, just like on this wall over here, I think this is going to look really, really amazing. So all in all, super happy with the acid wash. I think that's made all the difference. And of course, I've also painted the timber work with a coat of sealer, and that has made a very big difference as well, just to seal and protect the timbers. It's a satin finish, so it's given it a nice little luster as well, and I think brought out some of the colour. So yeah, pretty happy all in all with everything. I'm just sort of beating the weather before it starts to rain apparently. But yeah, definitely good progress this morning, unexpectedly. Well, Sunday morning, we're no slouches. We're up and about. What are you doing?
Well, re-oiling boards here to preserve them, and also it gives them a nice colour and it makes them look nice for a little bit longer.
Well, you capped it off.
Yeah, I've got a couple of little
things
to do over there, but yeah.
Dunskies. Oh, yeah, a little bit just here. Lovely. And then let's have a look at the other side. Wow. You happy with it?
Yeah.
That looks great.
Yeah,
I love all the little details, the hidey holes and down here as well. I love this little Grecian urn just poked in there. That's just fantastic. Yeah, how awesome. Well done. And the master's polishing off a beautiful day's work. Look at that, it's all just looking really clean and nice now. Beautiful. Can't wait to give it the old acid wash and seal it. It's going to look really nice, and with these hanging baskets off the railway spikes here and railway nails, they look really cool, and I love this little bit of detail here. You mean just like that? Yeah, I do. That's really good. Yeah, how good's that gonna be? Ah, oh, just glorious. Fantastic. Well done. Yeah, lovely little details. I love all this stuff here. We've got shells, we've got a bit of Roman pottery, more Roman pottery. Very nice. I guess the other really big news is that we've actually finished laying all the rockwork now, and that means that we could clean away all the sort of cement dust and everything else and my concrete mixer as well. Just so that we can, A, get better access into here, but start to think about leveling this off very accurately, to have a small slant to this edge, obviously, but really to be level so that when we put chairs and tables on it, it doesn't want to have a tilt to it. We've got some inbuilt drainage holes in the walls here, which will act as a last resort should the water not make it, out the back here. And there will also be a possibility for water to go in here too, because this will have a piece of core 10 in it, but water will be able to percolate through the gravel into this garden bed here to help keep the lavender and the vines that will be grown here alive. So that's coming up next. This is how easy it is to move these massive boards, and this is just a...
Say easy.
Yes, I do. Oh, it's all going pear-shaped. I'll come and help. All right, this morning, acid washing time again. This has now been thoroughly cleaned. We basically added a few more pieces here, and that's now been given another acid wash. It may need just one more. I've done two acid washes now on this wall, and this wall, which was previously finished, had got a bit of splatter on it, so it's had to be cleaned again. But the real thing is acid washing this area. Now this is probably needs one more go at it. I'm going to let it completely dry out and just see what the result is, and then based upon that go over it with a wire brush again, and then maybe another acid wash just to really clean it down, and it's ready for sealing, which would be fantastic. And as well as that, I've selected a board here and painted it with bitumen on the backside. That will go into this space here once I've sealed and washed and acid washed, finished all that. And the other side of it will be oiled just like the rest of these boards down here. Petrangelo did when he was here just over the weekend. So that's, so I've still got to do this little bit, which we couldn't re-oil because there was works going in front of it. And of course the new piece, so I'll do them at the same time, and then that'll complete this, you know, basically this whole area. We can start filling it with soil and planting. And the other thing that's sort of happening now, of course, is that we've acid washed the wall once, and it might just need one more go at it. I'm going to check that again tomorrow just to let it really fully dry out and then have a look at it. And I've oiled the timbers here, put the second timber in on top, which wasn't there previously. And then eventually, once all this dries and we've sealed the stonework, we can backfill this with more soil. And this will give us some herbs and things, little flowers growing underneath here, which I think will do particularly well. Maybe something like petunias, or I don't know, something nice. Okay, well, it's above 10 degrees, which means I can finally seal this stone. So at the moment it's just, you know, acid washed and cleaned. But I'm about to seal it with a sealer. It's a wet look concrete and paving sealer, which I've used on the other walls. And we've been very happy with the results of that. We've given it a gloss look because it's just easier to maintain and keep clean. Plus, it really does bring the colour out of the stone. The stone benefits from looking wet, and this gloss coat really does give it that wet look. So that's what's going on next. Okay, well, first coat is on. So I've just clear coated the top of the stonework, sealed it in with the stone and concrete sealer, and it's given it a nice, beautiful look. I mean, it's really brought the colour out. I will have to go over the timber with another coat of a finish coat on that too, because we've had to acid wash it several times. And but yeah, look at the difference the colour makes. It just sort of blends now with the background, matches it completely. So this is a very nice outcome. And yeah, unfortunately I ran out, so we'll have to go get another can, because I didn't get this little wall done. But, and of course the inside here, I'm also going to do the brickwork as well. So it's all sealed, easy to keep clean. And then we can also put on the tops in here, which are the timber tops, and seal those as well, because they will get a bit of, this is merbau, and merbau tends to run, kind of leaves a stain. You can see the stain mark right there. So by sealing it, we can then prevent it from being a permanent stain. I mean, just look at that. That's really glistening in the sunlight here. I'll zoom you in just so you can see. Yeah, the wet look really looks great. So once that's dried, we can plant in front of it. We put the soil in, put some plants in. It should make all the difference. And then I can move on to other things. I finally managed to get the clear coat on the stonework, the front and the back, including the brickwork at the back of the, you know, foreground walls there. And I've also recoated the timber just to get rid of the side effect of getting cement dust on it and having to wash it down with a bit of acid to get rid of the all traces of it. Just recoated them to clean it up a bit. And that's just looking so much better. Actually, it's probably darkened the timber a tiny bit, but I kind of like it. And yeah, so to see this now so close to where we can fill, we can backfill soil in front of the balustrading wall there, and then plant our herbs. At the, each end, we've got three different vines growing there, grape vines growing, which I'll have to plant. So that's to come as well. Now, I've still got my cement mixer here because I have to, next is to work on the floor, but at least the whole structure now is done. I do have the battens still owing. There's battens to go up. That is the very final bit of work still to be done on the framework, but everything else now has been sealed, painted, and basically made ready for the garden. So backfilled in here. And we'll put herbs. Each end will have a grapevine growing, And in the middle here, we'll put a bit of lavender as well, so that we basically create a sanctuary for bees as well as humans. And yeah, we're just also looking to put some plants into these baskets, which are hanging on the wall. But hasn't the colour of that wall just come up a treat? My goodness, it's fantastic. So yeah, the only thing left on this is just a piece of timber across here, a bit of that white pine that we cut down from our forest here. We'll use a bit of that. And then yeah, it's sort of looking really finished. I'm loving it. Sometimes capturing this building is quite difficult because the sunlight and the shadows are so strong that you can't see the detail, but you can see that we've sealed the tops of this now, so that's got its first coat. I might just do one more coat on that just to give it a bit more hardiness. That one will get a bit more abuse because of dogs and everything else. But this is looking really good, so I'm pretty confident that we can pretty much plant stuff in the baskets, but put the soil in the back here after we put a bit of drainage in the very bottom, and we can plant herbs through. So we're just going to have a cascade of herbs, oregano, thyme, rosemary, you know, this sort of thing, just coming out of here. And as mentioned before, there's a bit of lavender here, some vines either end, which will climb up the structure and cover it over and provide shade during summer. So I think all in all, it's come together really, really nice, and I really like this. Even though I polished the surface to make it a bit smoother on your hands, I was able to find an antique-y stain to kind of make it look like it wasn't. So my intention is to sit it into a bed of cement just so that it doesn't rock or move, and put a few screws either side just to lock it into place, fill the holes with some putty and a bit more sealer, and then that's it. That will be done. Still got the battens to put up on here, which I'm having troubles locating actually, because people don't save battens. They tend to break up and be tossed, so I'm having to find, you know, whatever I can find. It's quite difficult. Anyway, that's the update for today. Very happy.